Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, we'll cover Google Ads conversion tracking, including how to track conversion values to report on performance and optimize your campaigns. We're going to walk through the steps to set up conversion tracking using Google Tag Manager, including how to set up variables to capture values. By taking the time to set up Google Ads conversion tracking, you'll be able to report on the performance of your campaigns. Conversion tracking can also automatically optimize your campaigns if you're using automated bidding or running Performance Max campaigns in Google Ads. Let's head to our Google Ads account. We start by navigating to Goals and then select Summary under Conversions. And let's click New Conversion Action. Today we're going to set up the dedicated Google Ads conversion tracking, so let's select Website on the left. Now we need to enter our website's domain. And click Scan. If you've already installed the Google Tag or Google Analytics on your website, then you'll see suggestions for how to track conversions. If you do see options automatically listed, then I want you to scroll down and look for the option to create a conversion manually, like we can see here. So I want you to go ahead and click Add a Conversion Action Manually. We can now select a category for the conversion. I'm going to select Purchase for my conversion, but you can select the category that best describes the action you're going to be tracking. Then we enter a conversion name. I'm going to enter Purchase and then Ads in brackets. I like to add the method I'm using for tracking the conversion at the end of the name to make it easy to identify in my Google Ads account. But you don't have to do this if you don't want to. Since we're going to be tracking values for each conversion, let's select Use Different Values for each conversion. And I'm going to set the default value to 0. This will mean if a value is not set, then the value will be reported as 0 in Google Ads. I'm going to leave the rest of the defaults for my conversion. To learn more about the ways you can configure conversions in Google Ads, I recommend joining my Google Ads course and checking out my other resources. I've included links in the description below this video if you'd like to learn more. Okay, now that we've configured our conversion, let's click Done at the bottom. We can see our conversion, so let's click Save and Continue. We're now given the instructions for tracking the conversion on our website. Since we're going to use Google Tag Manager, let's select the Use Google Tag Manager tab. Now we need to copy the conversion ID. And we also need to copy the conversion label. In order to pass values to Google Ads, we need details about each transaction to be available to Google Tag Manager. This is done using an e-commerce data layer. I'm going to walk through the steps to do this for a WooCommerce store running on WordPress. However, if you're using another e-commerce platform, you can find links to my other e-commerce tracking tutorials in the description below this video. And if you'd like to see me cover other e-commerce platforms, please let me know in the comments. Okay, let's head to WordPress. I've already logged into WordPress, so the first thing we need to do is install Google Tag Manager. To do this, let's select Plugins. And then Add New. Now let's search for Google Tag Manager. Let's install the GTM for WordPress plugin. And let's activate the plugin. Now let's click Settings. We need to enter our container ID from Google Tag Manager. So let's head to Google Tag Manager to find this. We can find the container ID at the top. It starts with GTM and then a dash. Let's copy this. Now let's head back to WordPress. And let's paste our container ID. Make sure there isn't a space at the start or end of the container ID, as this will cause problems. Now, if you want to continue using another plugin to add Google Tag Manager to your WordPress site, you'll need to change the container code option to off. For example, if you're using Google's Sitekit plugin to add Google Tag Manager, and you want to continue using that plugin, then just make sure you change this to off. Since I'm adding Google Tag Manager to WordPress for the first time, and I'm not using another plugin to add Google Analytics, let's ensure this is set to on. Now let's click Save Changes. And let's select the Integration tab. And choose WooCommerce. Now let's enable the option to track e-commerce. And let's click Save Changes. This will now mean that transaction details are pushed to the data layer when people make a purchase on the website. To check that this is working, let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now let's click Preview. Tag Assistant loads, and we can enter the URL of our website. Now let's click Connect. Our website loads along with Tag Assistant. Now let's navigate to the shop. Let's add an item to our cart. And view the cart. Now let's check out. Enter our details. And place the order. Now that we've made a purchase, let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And let's select the purchase event on the left. Now we can select the Data Layer tab. And this shows us all of the information that has been pushed to the data layer for our transaction. The data layer variables we need to configure Google Ads conversion tracking are the currency, transaction ID, and value in the e-commerce object. Now that we know these details are being pushed to the data layer, the next step is to configure variables to capture these values in Google Tag Manager. So let's close Tag Assistant. Close our website. And let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Now let's navigate to Variables. And let's click New to create a new user-defined variable. Let's name the variable e-commerce currency. And let's select Variable Configuration. We need to choose Data Layer Variable as the type. And for the Data Layer Variable name, let's enter e-commerce.currency. This will capture the currency value from the data layer we saw in Tag Assistant. Now let's save the variable. And let's click New again. Let's name this variable e-commerce transaction ID. Let's select Variable Configuration. And choose Data Layer Variable as the type. Now let's enter e-commerce.transaction_ID as the data layer variable name. And let's save the variable. Now let's create one more variable. Let's click New. Let's name the variable e-commerce value. Now let's select Variable Configuration and choose Data Layer Variable as the type. Let's enter e-commerce.value as the data layer variable name. And let's save the variable. We've now created three variables that will capture the currency, transaction ID, and value from the data layer. So the next step is to create our Google Ads conversion tag. To do this, let's navigate to Tags. And let's click New to create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Ads Conversion Purchase. Now let's select Tag Configuration. Choose Google Ads, and then Google Ads Conversion Tracking. Since this is the first Google Ads tag we're creating in this Google Tag Manager container, we can see there is an alert saying Conversion Linker Tag Missing in Container. If you already have a Conversion Linker Tag in your container, then you won't see the alert and you won't need to complete these next steps. But since we are seeing the alert, let's click Create. Let's name the tag Google Ads Conversion Linker. And let's remove the All Pages trigger. And add the Initialization All Pages trigger. Now let's save the tag. We're now back on the Google Ads Conversion tag, so we need to paste the conversion ID we copied from Google Ads. And we need to paste the conversion label. Next, we can add the e-commerce value variable for the conversion value. We add the e-commerce transaction ID variable for the transaction ID. And we add the e-commerce currency variable for the currency code. Now let's scroll down and select triggering. We just want our tag to fire when a purchase has been made, so let's click the plus sign on the top right corner to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Purchase. Now let's select Trigger Configuration and choose Custom Event. For the event name, let's enter Purchase, all lowercase. And let's save the trigger. This will mean our Google Ads conversion tag only fires once someone has made a purchase. Now let's save the tag. And let's click Preview. Tag Assistant loads. We enter the URL of our website. And click Connect. Our website loads. And now we can complete a purchase to check that everything is working. Let's view an item. Add the item to our cart. Let's check out. And let's complete the purchase. Now we can open the Tag Assistant tab. And let's select the purchase event on the left. We can see our Google Ads conversion tag has fired. We can also select the Google Ads tag ID at the top. And this shows us the conversion has been sent to Google Ads. Let's select this. We can see the transaction ID, value, and currency code that has been captured and sent to Google Ads, so we know it's working. When you're happy that your conversion tracking is working correctly, you can head back to Google Tag Manager and publish the changes to your live website. Once you've published your container and someone makes a purchase, you'll see the conversion and conversion value appear in your Google Ads account. You can also adjust how they're used for reporting and for automatic optimization of your campaigns by editing the conversion. To learn even more about Google Ads, please take a moment to check out my course and other resources in the description below this video. And to stay up to date with Google Ads, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.